Now we have come to the supremely pure transcendental place in the forest of the Lohavan. This is it. The ashram of Durvasa Rishi. I first came here with the Srila Gurudev in about 97. And there was one old sadhu living in a small hut. And he had a deity. Very beautiful deity of the Durvasa Rishi. And he was very old, he was about to leave this world. Give this deity of the Durvasa Rishi to you and this land. So then, just shortly after that, sadhu passed away. And Srila constructed this magnificent ashram and temple on the site of the ancient ashram of the Durvasa Rishi. Darshan, think about going. Charvani. So, we probably won't be here until the program because we have so many places to go. So, we'll have to see the Durvasa Rishi through the ears. And there are also many Gurudev, many dharamas about his pastimes all the way around. Outside. Yeah, around the ashram, outside of the ashram. So we'll go and see those. They illustrate the important role that the Durvasa Rishi has played in so many pastimes. So perhaps you know that once Narad Muni, he was traveling everywhere. And he was glorifying the wife of one rishi named Anusuya. His name was Atri Rishi and his wife was Anusuya. Narad went to Lakshmi, he went to Sati, the wife of Lord Shiva, Parvati. He went to Saraswati, the wife of Lord Brahma. Everywhere he went, he said, there is no chaste lady like Anusuya in all the three worlds. So the wife of Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva and Lord Narayan, they are proud that they are very chaste wives, but they felt diminished that Anusuya was being glorified above them. Is the same person,
So
how can this human lady be so chaste more than us? So they were all nagging their husbands. Go and test her, go and test
her.
So then, Brahma, Shiva and Vishnu to pacify the nagging wives, they came here, very nearby is the ashram of Atri Rishi. And they took the form of Brahmanas, begging. So they came, oh, Bhagavati Bhikshanti. And Anusuya came to give some alms to them.
И Анасура вышла для того, чтобы дать им какие-то пожертвования.
So to test the justice, they said, we don't accept any alms from a lady unless she is naked.
И она вынесла им свои подношения, они сказали, вы знаете, мы подношения не берем, не берем от тех женщин, которые не вышли к нам нагими.
Then she said, okay, wait there.
Она сказала, хорошо, подождите.
So she went to her husband.
Она подошла к мужу.
And by his trance, he could understand this was not something ordinary.
Он погрузился в физический транс, и в своем трансе он видел, что их личность это экстраординарная.
So he told her, okay, you can give alms naked, but you should say, you should become like small babies.
И муж посоветовал.
Because one can be naked even with a baby.
Это женщина посоветовала на сына, сказала, хорошо, ты можешь дать им свои подаяния, будучи ногой, но скажи перед этим, чтобы они приняли облик маленьких детей.
So then she came and stated her conditions, and then they became Brahma, Shiva, and Vishnu became three babies in the arms of Anasuya.
Anasuya вышла, выдвинула свои условия, они с ними согласились, и тогда Брама, Шива, Вишну, они приняли облик детей и к ним на ручки забрались.
So now Lakshmi and Parvati and Saraswati, they were regretting their activities because their husbands went to test the chastity of Anasuya and never came back. So then they also took the form of a Brahmani, female Brahmins, and they came there begging to Anasuya. What do you want? Oh, please give us our husbands back. So, then Brahma, Shiva and Vishnu, they expanded. And in one form, their original form, they went back to their wives. And in an expanded form, they stayed and were raised as the children of Anasuya.
Брама, Шива и Вишну, они разделились на две формы. В одной форме они остались Анасуи, как ее дети, которых она растила, и в другой форме они отправились обратно по домам своим женам.
So the expansion of Lord Vishnu became the son of Anasuya, the great sage Dattatreya.
Дататрея, экспансия великого Господа Вишну.
And the Lord Shiva, his expansion is Durvasa Rishi. So Durvasa Rishi is the form of Lord Shiva. So we see that Durvasa Rishi, when he grew up, he became a very ferocious sage. From his austerities, he's so powerful that he can curse you. If you say you will die, you will die. If you say you should become a crocodile, turn into a
crocodile.
So around the Durvasa Rishi, everyone is on their best behavior because he very easily becomes pleased, but he very easily becomes angry also. So he's involved in so many pastimes in Satya, Treta, Dwarka Yuga. And Kali
Yuga.
So perhaps you know that the five Pandavas are the sons of Kunti Devi. But they were not conceived by a husband Pandu, they were conceived by the demigods. The Yudhishthira Raj is the incarnation of Dhamaraj, Karna is the son of the sun god, Arjuna is the conceived by Indra, like this, Bhimsen by Vayudev, and Nakula and Sahadev from the Ashwini Kumaras. But how is it that Kunti Devi had the power to call the demigods to conceive children? Because of the benedictions of Durvasa Rishi.
Но само по себе вот эта способность призывать полубогов и сочинать с ней детей у Кунти
пространство, ты Пандавас или Кандависпа.
Поэтому Бог благословил вас, и Петра Пандава, и весь этот мир.
Perhaps you know that every day Shrimati Radhika, from Yavat, she goes and she cooks in the kitchen of Mother Yashoda. How did it happen? By the blessing of Durvasa Rishi.
Возможно, вы знаете, что каждый день Шримати Радхарани из Явы, она направляется в Нанду, он готовит на кухне Яшоды Майи. Как это случилось? Как же по благословению Дурваса Муни?
Once Дурваса Риши came to the palace of Вришабана Махарадж, and Радхарани served him, and he gave her a blessing that whatever you cook will taste more sweet than nectar, and whoever will eat it can never be defeated. So because many demons were coming to Vrindavan, Mother Yashoda was always worried about her son and thinking how to protect him. And when she heard that Radhika had a benediction from Durvasa, then she insisted, Radhika should come and cook in my kitchen every day. If Krishna will eat the food that she's cooked, then by the power of Durvasa Rishi, then no demons can defeat him.
И тогда ей пришла в голову такая идея, что поскольку у Шримати Радхарани у нее есть это благословение, дарованное ею Дурваса Риши, что тот, кто будет кушать пищу, приготовленную ею, никогда не будет побежден, то она подумала, что Кришна будет полностью защищен, если он будет кушать блюдо, которое приготовила Шримати Радхарани. Поэтому мама Яшода пригласила Радхарани готовить каждый день на своей кухне.
If you come to this temple on Vasant Panchami, you'll see thousands and thousands of Vrishbhasis crossing the Jamuna in boats, carrying so many preparations on their head and they offer to the Vasant Rishi here.
Если на Vasant Panchami вы собираетесь пересекать реку с той стороны Матуры и добраться сюда, вы увидите, что огромное количество брахман, они съезжаются сюда с приготовлениями на своих головах, несут все их Дурваса Риши.
Even today?
Даже по сегодняшний день.
Why?
Почему?
When the other gopis of Vrindavan heard that Radharani had a benediction, then they also wanted a benediction. So the many gopis of Braj, they made so many delicious preparations and they set out to come
here.
But when they got on the bank of Jamuna, it was flooded and they couldn't cross. So they asked Krishna, what can we do? Krishna said, I can give you a mantra whereby you will be able to cross the flooded Jamuna. So the mantra was, Krishna Nitya Brahmachari. You know that Krishna is a Brahmachari? Yes. So they said the mantra and Jamuna gave way and they came. And they gave so many preparations to Durvasa and Durvasa ate all of them. But when they went to cross, they couldn't cross again. So they came to Durvasa and he gave a mantra, Durvasa Nirahari. That means Durvasa doesn't eat anything. So then gopis were confused. Every day we go secretly and play with Krishna in the forest. So how can he be Nitya Brahmachari? And we bought so many preparations to Durvasa, he ate everything. How can he be Nirahari? So they came to see Krishna and they asked him, what is the meaning of this? So see Krishna said, because I have no contrary to buddhi. I never have the ego that I am the doer. So if someone has no ego that they are doer, then they actually have no karma.
Что он за что-то отвечает, это означает,
consciousness is not involved in this world.
Сознание этих людей, оно не погружено в этот мир.
So brahmachari means brahmachari, one who is moving in Brahman.
Brahmachari
in the truth.
Brahmachari,
the transcendental place.
Всегда находится на трансцендентном плане, это всегда пребывает в истине.
So because the rasa, he has no contact to buddhi, he is not, you are saying he is eating, but actually he is not eating.
А поскольку у rasa нет настроения любви, то что он является действующим, поэтому то, что он съел, это только для внешних глаз он съел, на самом деле он не вовлечен в все это.
Krishna said, one who sees action in inaction and inaction in action actually sees the truth. But really, Krishna is a brahmachari. Why? Because all gopis there, a brahmachari means who never talks with a woman, never touches a woman, never looks at a woman, never associates with a woman. So, Krishna is brahmachari. Why? Because all the gopis, they are not women, they are his own shakti.
Но Кришна является действительно брахмачари, настоящим брахмачари. Кто такой брахмачари? Это та личность, которая никогда не смотрит на женщину, никогда не касается женщин, никогда не разговаривает с ними, никогда не думает о них. И Кришна в действительности не встречается с братья Гопи. Почему? Потому что все они являются его собственными шахтами.
And Krishna's katha is true. Krishna said, I am not acting out of ego. Why? Because everything Krishna does with Gopis is acted only from pure praying.
И когда Кришна, каждое слово, которое говорит Кришна, является правдой. Почему? Потому что каждое слово Тригатхи, оно ведомо премой, чистой любовью, трансцендентной любовью.
So, there are so many pastimes with Durvasa Rishi. You know that very famously, Durvasa from here went to Mathura and he gave a course to Amrish Maharaj.
Однажды отсюда Дурваса Риши отправился в Мадхуру и там пробовал
But when the, he sent one fiery creature, a demon, to attack Amrish Maharaj, the Sudarshan Chakra came, killed that demon and turned against the Durvasa.
И Дурваса настолько разозлился на Амриша Махараджа, что он назвал на него огненную демоницу. Но появилась Сударшана Чакра Господа и погналась за Дурвасой Муни.
And for one year the Chakra chased him all over the universe. Brahma could not save him, Shiva could not save him even.
И в течение целого года эта Чакра преследовала Дурвасу Риши, и никто бы не мог спасти.
So in the end he went to Lord Narayan because it was his chakra. And he said, please save me. But even Bhagavan said, I cannot save you. He said, but you are independent. It's your chakra, you are independent. Lord Narayan said, Aham Bhakta Prani, no, he has Swatantra Ivatuja. I am not independent. I am controlled by the love of my Lord. And he glorified Amrish
Maharaj.
And told him, if a thorn goes in your foot, you cannot take it out from your shoulder. So, where you have made the offense, you have to go back there and beg for forgiveness. So, the Vasarishi went back to Amrish Maharaj and begged for forgiveness. And Amrish Maharaj prayed. Actually, for the whole year, he was praying for the benefit of the Vasarishi. And the Sudarshan Chakra became cool and then disappeared.
The
Rasa Rishi said, Aho Anantadasam, Aho Anantadasam, Mahatam Dastam Adhyane. He said, today I have seen the glories of the Vaishnavas. Even though I tried to kill him, he was praying for my benefit. So, in this way, you see, sometimes people think Amrish Maharaj is a Vaishnava and Durvasa is a yogi. But actually, because Durvasa is expansion of Lord Shiva, and it is said Vaishnava Anam Yata Shambhu, that Lord Shiva is the greatest Vaishnava. So Durvasa Rishi is a Vaishnava, but he plays the role of a yogi in order to glorify the Vaishnavas. To glorify Bhakti. So perhaps you know also that the grandson of Krishna, Sambha, and his friends, they played a trick on rishis by dressing him up as a pregnant girl. And asking, oh please, Maharaj, please tell us, will it be a boy or a girl?
Они пришли к мудрецам, сами друзьями, они засунули сами одежды в живот, засунули бытовую культуру одежды всякие и стали спрашивать мудрецов, умеется над ними, кто тут родится, мальчик или девочка.
Don't try to play a joke on Durvasa Rishi.
А не надо Durvasa Rishi.
He was among those sages and he became angry and he said, you will give birth to a lump of iron which will destroy your whole dynasty. So previously, many years before, Durvasa Rishi came to Dwarka. And Krishna was honored him because Krishna, the Brahmanas are very dear to Krishna. So Krishna had his servants offer him a feast. But he didn't take it. Then in the middle of the night, at midnight, he got up, he said, I want sweet rice. So then Rukmini made some sweet rice. And Rukmini and Krishna offered it to them. So then the Durvasa Muni didn't eat it. He said, I want to ride on a chariot. So then Krishna bought his chariot. Then the Rasa said, no, no, you should take the horses off the chariot. I want Rukmini to pull the chariot. So then the Rasa got on the chariot and Rukmini was trying to pull, but she just fell on the ground. And Krishna was just, whatever the Rasa said, he was doing it very
well.
Because he was showing the ideal Grihastha householder. If sadhu will come, whatever they want to just do that, don't complain, don't make any conditions, just follow them. So then when Rukmini collapsed and she could not pull, then the Rasa Rishi said, bring the sweet rice. Then he told Krishna, smear it all over your body. So the wife should follow the husband, so what was left over, Rukmini took and she smeared the sweet rice all over. So then in the end, the Rasa Rishi said, I am very pleased with you. So I give you a benediction that wherever my remnants have touched, then you will be invincible. But see, Krishna put the sweet rice all over his body, but not on the soles of his feet. So that lump of iron that appeared under the cloth of Sambha, they, under the guidance of Ugrasen Maharaj, they followed it down and threw it in the ocean, and there was one piece left, they threw that in the ocean.
шар, такую стружку и выбросили на океан.
And the filings, iron filings washed up on the shore of Prabhupada. And they grew to be razor sharp reeds growing. So when the Yadu dynasty came there, they got drunk, they pulled them up and they began to fight and they all killed each other. And the small piece that was left over was swallowed by a fish, and the fish was caught by a hunter, and when he cut open the fish, he took it and he made the head of a arrow. And see, Krishna was relaxing under a tree with his foot like this, and that hunter shot the arrow into the foot of Krishna. In this way, all the words of the Vasa Rishi came through. But we should know this lila of the disappearance of the Yadu dynasty, it was only like hypnotism, magic shown by Krishna, that was seen by lowly persons. Because the demigods, the materialistic persons saw the Yadu dynasty were destroyed and Krishna was killed. The demigods saw that all the Yadu dynasty, they went in airplanes to the spiritual world, and the pure devotees saw that Krishna, he didn't disappear, he's still here in Brahma. So though the lila is considered illusory, it's still the bhava of respect of Krishna respecting the words of Dharmasa Rishi. To teach the world, don't offend the Brahmanas, don't offend the Vaishnavas. So Srila Gurudev established the Rasa Rishi here, and Srila Gurudev installed, it's the only place in the world where Srila Gurudev installed the deity of Yamuna Devi here, riding on a crocodile. So everyone can pray, oh the Rasa Rishi, please give me a benediction that I can become a very good cook and assist Radhika in cooking for Sri Krishna. Все вы можете молиться, Дарваса Риши, Дарваса Риши, очень хорошим поваром, и для того, чтобы ассистировать Радхике на кухне мамы Яшоды. Дарваса Риши!